Hello, it's Mike, nostressmike.com. And I had somebody, I mentioned that one time I lived out in San Jose, and I had somebody request that I say a little something about it. And so I thought, well, you know, and that started me thinking, because, you know, it's been a while since all this happened. And, but I went there in 75, maybe 76, maybe somewhere right around there. The Patricia Hirsch was going on at that time, and I went. My dad had a stroke, and then when my dad had a stroke, he was paralyzed. And I got to remember, here I was be 23, 24, be about 25. I was 25, maybe 26. And so I was still young, and I didn't really know what this stuff was. It's one of these times when you listen to people. When you're young and you're dumb, you listen to others. And I did. Everybody told me just let him rest and you know, just leave him alone. And they would get, family members would get mad because I'd go visit him every day. I'd take my kids, and they were like 1, 2 years old, something like that. And, you know, I'd get him and take him out, go fishing, you know, put him in a wheelchair and went out there. And you know, everybody's getting mad, and they said, well, you're making him bad, you know. And let you know, things changed, because when my wife had the stroke and she was paralyzed, it was keep her active. And man, I mean, I didn't let her rest. I mean, when she was resting, I was giving her massage. I mean, I was doing all kinds of stuff to get her back going again. I learned, don't listen, because these people don't know what they're saying. Look for results and see on anything. Look at the results and see who's had favorable results, and that's what you do. You just don't go along with what science or the medical people tell you. Think. They don't think. They got policies that they work on. To keep their license, they have to do this stuff. I want stuff getting done, so that's why it's a little different. But anyway, so it got bad, and I said, that's it. So I moved out to California. I was there for 1 year, almost to the day, and it was an experience. I lived in San Jose, Los Gatos area is where I lived. And when I first went out there, I was working in a bar. I had a family member that owned a supper club. And it was a Polynesian supper club. And I was bartending. And I was the fancy bartender, flipping bottles and doing all that kind of, I was doing like that. That's why I had to learn and do all this kind of stuff. And it was interesting. And I did that, I think, for about 6 months, and I don't know what happened. I don't know why I left there, but anyway, when we were living there, we lived close to the restaurant, and we lived upstairs, and my daughter, she was 2, maybe 3 years old, went through the window out on the roof of the porch downstairs. And so she was walking around there on the roof like that. Everybody was panicking, and it gave me a call. I come over there, and there she was walking around on the roof. So I had her wait, and I went upstairs and got in the window and had her come to me, and then I grabbed her and stuff. So that was different. And so that's what happened when we were there. And also, we were driving down the road, and it was the one thing about that part of the country. I mean, it's all one city. The only difference is you'll see a sign and it'll tell you you're in a different city. But other than that, it all looks the same. And so we're driving down the road, and I don't know what time it was. It was night. And we're driving down the road, and on the left side, a gas station was getting robbed. And so then I pulled over to the side. I had my wife and kids get out of the truck, and I turned around and went back to the robbery. And I come driving up there, honk my horn, and they were shooting the guy, the gas station attendant, and the robber. They were shooting at each other. I come driving up there, honk my horn, and so then they started shooting at me, because neither one knew, you know, the gas station attendant didn't know if I was part of the guy robbing them, and the guy robbing didn't know what, you know, so everybody was shooting at me. And so I went on after the guy. And he went back to his houses behind there. I went back in there and I started driving around. I didn't find him. And I went back to the station and my wife and kids were there. And the guy was Mexican. And so my wife, since she's from Guatemala, she could talk to him. And she was talking to him and everything's okay. He didn't get hurt and all this kind of stuff. And so I thought, oh, we better get out of here before the police get here. So we loaded up and then we took off. And that was the first shooting. I think that was the first shooting that I've ever been in as a, no, it's not even the first shooting I got in. I've been in shootings before that, but, well, it was the first shooting in California. And so then my first shooting in California. And I got to remember, we're only married 3, maybe 4 years at the most. So my wife is still learning. She doesn't know who I am and what I do. So she was still kind of, you know, what is this guy, you know? So doing this kind of stuff. This is stuff down in Central America. You know, shooting and everybody getting shot and getting robbed. This is stuff going on in Central America. It's happening here in the United States. So there's, and then I'm doing it. And so, you know, it's kind of, you know, she's trying to figure out, who is this guy? And then after that, the last 4 months, I think, I was working for Pizza Hut in California. And at that time, there was three, maybe four in the San Francisco area. This was considered San Francisco area. And they weren't making money, none at all, really bad. And so I started working for them, and I said, well, let's work out a deal. And I said, I'll take that, you know, which store is the worst? And they gave me the worst store. And I said, okay, now what it is, I'm going to let me have half of the profit. That's going to be my pay. It's half of the profit. And, you know, they said, well, there's no profit. And I said, yeah, when I get it, there'll be a profit. And I'm going to get half of the profit. And then, so then they thought, hey, this guy's crazy, you know, so young, what do I know, you know? And so then I got the place and we started doing pizzas, 2 for the price of 1. And man, we got business, a lot of business. And at that time, they charge you extra if it's going to be carry out. I was no charging extra for carry out. And matter of fact, 2 for the price of 1 was for carry out only. And so, I mean, we went through a lot of pizza. We did really well. And I made money. And then they started calling me. And first they wrote me and they said, you can't do that. Then they called me and they said, you can't do that. You know, you didn't get approval and stuff like that. Well, you know, how am I going to get profit? By the way, you're doing it. There's no profit. So we'll do it my way and I'm not going to talk to you about it. So that's how I was able to do good. And it was funny because it was on a Friday night and the place was full and I'm behind the counter on the Pizza Hut. And then the door opened and a guy came in with a ski mask, you know, and a coat, long trench coat. And I thought, what the hell is this? So I walked around in front of the counter and then right when I did, so I met him. And when I met him, he opened up his coat and he pulled out a shotgun. And when he pulled it out and lifted it up, I just knocked it up in the air, and then I whacked him. And then, you know, so then he's, you know, like that. And then I thought, oh, shit, I screwed up. Pizza Hut's policy was, when you're robbed, you give them the money, you know. And so then I thought, oh, man, I screwed up, you know. And then here comes his buddy, comes in the door. And see, under normal conditions, I would have beat the hell out of that guy and killed his buddy. But, hey, that's against the policy. So, so here, I'm straightening the guy up. I give him back his shotgun. And then we go through the robbery kind of thing. And I'm laying on the floor. And when I'm laying on the floor, I'm thinking, I just gave up my life. My life right now is in the hands of this stupid weirdo that's robbing the place. And I let him have my life. And he's over here tapping me on the foot with his shotgun. And I'm thinking, come on up here by my hands. I'll take that damn thing away from you again. And but I say, he just, you know, where's the money, where's the money? And finally, they left. My wife was close to the back door, laying on the floor on the back door. When they were going out, they poked it in her ribs, and that terrified her. You know, she's not into violence. I'm the one in the violence. She's not. And so then she was scared. And they went out the back door. I locked it. I hit the main switch. All the lights went out. And then one of the other policies from Pizza Hut was no firearms. You don't bring firearms into the Pizza Hut. So my gun was out in the truck. So I had to go out the front door, get in my truck. I could hear them going over the fence. We had a chain link fence back there. And they were going over the fence. And I'm over here getting my gun. And I ran down the street until I got to the place with the next opening so I could see the alley. Because that's what they went the fence, got in the alley, and they're going down the alley. So I ran down there, and I got in position, and they didn't come. They went the other direction. So that was the end of that. And so then we called the police, and we went through all that kind of stuff. And then that's when my wife says, now see, now we've been there about a year. And she says, well, maybe we shouldn't be here. She's starting to figure out that I don't put up with this stuff. And, you know, so she thought maybe I better not be in a place like this. So that's when we came back to Kansas. And like I said, I had a van. And well, before I had the van, I had a Mustang Mach 1. And it was funny because I got into race riots, and at that time they were going to burn cars and stuff like that. And so I thought, okay, so I got me a van, and I steel plated the door, so you know, at least I can drive without getting shot so easy. And that's the van that I had that I took out to California. And I'll tell you, that was such a weird, sick place. This was back, let's see, like say 74, 75, I don't know, back in that day. That place was so weird. I took my canoe, and I had to have the canoe registered. How do you register a damn canoe? There's no motor, there's no nothing. You got it in your backyard, you know, so I had to have that. Then you had to have, went to the lake to go canoeing, but you have to have a permit for the lake. I said, well, hell, I'm not going to do that. So I went to the creek. And then they got me in the creek, and they said, you have to have a permit for the waterways, California waterways, for a canoe. Yeah, and then my truck, it didn't have the emission system that California is supposed to have. So I was supposed to do that, too. And that's when we said, that's it. We're leaving. So that's my time out in California. It sucked. The people there, you California folk, you're listening to me? I'm telling you, you suck. You have no balls. You're a bunch of cowards. I'm telling you. And I'll tell you to your face. I have no problem with it. Because California folk are cowards. And they're really weird. And they have not many have morals. Now, the exception to all this stuff is, I'm talking about the ones that live in the cities. These people are sick. Their lives are based on money, and they're not right. They're not right at all. They don't understand common decency. They don't understand that. And they don't do it, and they don't expect it from others. And that's why. Now, I will admit, I got some people from California that are subscribe and make comments, stuff like that. None of them are in town. Well, I guess there might be a few that are in some kind of city. But anybody watches my stuff, they got to have some degree of morals. But those people, they don't. They're really, really weird. They've allowed their cities, their counties, their state, just to get really weird. That's why I don't care. I don't care about it. And I'm getting the same way for the rest of the nation, because they're all getting the same way. I mean, nobody, if you think you have morals, then live by your morals. This is what I try to get across to people. They don't do that out in California. Morals have nothing to do with anything. But anyway, so when I talk about California and some of my experiences, I say I lived there 1 year, and I had gotten a lot of problems when I was there. But anyway, I don't put up problems, so that's why I don't do good. But anyway, this is Mike, nostretchmike.com.